Welcome all of you. I heartily welcome all of you by giving this virtual rose as a token of warm welcome, because this is your first day in your college life. You have entered in a college life. Best wishes for the new academic year. I am very happy for you. These days everybody is learning online, and I am also taking your online classes of economics. So welcome in my online classes. First of all, I would like to congratulate you for succeeding in standard 10th, as you have passed standard 10th and you have selected commerce field. See, commerce is the only field which will show the good days, good future to India. You have selected a perfect field. See, why? When you are learning economics, what are the avenues of after learning the economics? There are many fields, many prospectus after completing the economics education in economics. See, which are those fields? What careers you can choose after completing the economic studies in economics? See, most common jobs are, you can become a lawyer, an economist, a financial analyst, or actuary. Those are the specified unique jobs. Also, you can become market research analyst, economics professor, which are other potential jobs, accountant, statistician. And which are the non-traditional jobs? See, which are the famous jobs? Securities, commodities and financial securities sales agents, finance or business reporter, environmental economist and personal finance advisor. Apart from that, okay, you can also become economic consultant, compensation and benefits manager, financial analyst, credit analyst, actuary, market research analyst and many more. By the time you complete your HSC or by the time you complete your graduation, there can be many new fields which would have arisen. So it's a very good chance and great opportunity for you to do a career in economics or in commerce. See, economist is a vast subject which comprises of many things. See, it comprises of many things, many new subjects, many topics under it. And you don't have to worry for economics. I am going to teach you economics in a very easy way. You will be able to understand economics forever. Okay, so don't need to worry about it. See, this is the first page of your economics book, and this is the last page of your economics book. And this travel, from first page to last travel, I assure you that I will make it a very happy and successful journey. This is your book of economics, standard 11, Maharashtra Board, HSC Board. And these are the contents. What is meant by contents? It is index. See, it is the index which shows how many topics or how many chapters you have this year in your economic syllabus. See, there are total 10 topics or 10 chapters included in your syllabus of economics standard 11 book. And we will start with first chapter, that is basic concepts in economics. See, and what board expects from you? See, that is called as competency statements. Board expects, after learning this chapter 1, you should be able to differentiate between natural science and social science, recognize and appreciate the diversity of views of various economists, analyze the various definitions of economics, differentiate between microeconomics and macroeconomics. See, micro and macroeconomics, explain the basic concepts of microeconomics and macroeconomics with realistic examples. See, all these terminologies which is included over here, all these terminologies is new for you. You must not have ever had or heard any of the terms or any of the topic, but you are not at all required to worry for this. Believe in me, I am there for you to teach economics in a very easy way, in a very lucid manner. So your economics, the base of economics will be fixed and permanent. Okay, because you have to choose any of the career which I have shown you, or the new career which arises by the time. Because your base of economics must be good, and I am going to make you a very well strong economist. See, let's start the day with the happy note, that thing which you like. This is the happy note for you. 25% reduction in the syllabus. See, with this this academic year, everybody is stuck by COVID. So government has released one praise note, and according to that praise note, 25% syllabus has been reduced. Okay, it is reduced means it is declared that it is, you should learn it by yourself. Okay, you should learn that syllabus by yourself. That is called as 25% reduction. Okay, that is called as self study. See, this is as per the GR which is released by Maharashtra Board. As it is in Marathi, I have translated it for you in English wherever it is required. And I will always notify you when there are any additions or whenever there are any changes in the government policy. See, only for this academic year 2020 and 2021, because everybody is stuck by corona, for standard 11 for the subject of economics, see, these are the changes. Okay, on the three pages there are the changes are shown, and as well in the lesson number 1, that is basic concepts of economics, there are 2 points given on page number 4 and page number 5, which are given on column 1 and column 2, which are considered to be self study. Okay, which are considered to be self study means you have to learn by your own, and that will not be included in the valuation, means that the questions will not be asked on it. Okay, so whenever we come across this page number 4 and page number 5 and columns number 1 and 2, I will notify you. See, 25% reduction. Page number 2 of that GR, and this is the third page of that GR. Now let's start with economics. Okay, be fresh, active. See, we are going to start with lesson number 1, that is chapter number 1, basic concepts in economics. Okay, see, let's start chapter 1, basic concepts in economics. Okay, what is meant by economics? See, today's world is marked by scientific inventions and discoveries. This remarkable scientific progress enables to probe into question, what is science? Science is the systematic body of knowledge or language. There are two main types of sciences. See, what is meant by probing into? Probing into means searching in deep. See, today's world is marked by scientific, there are many scientific inventions and discoveries these days. See, even the coronavirus is a scientific invention, and everybody is behind discovering the injection on it, right? So that is what, those are the discoveries. So day by day, every day, there are many scientific inventions and discoveries coming across. Okay, and everybody is searching deep into the question, what is the science then? So science is a systematic study. All of you must be knowing, science is a systematic study. But you must be wondering, I am learning economics, why there is science is mentioned in economics? I have not taken science stream, I have taken the commerce stream. Then why we are talking about the science in the first lesson of the economics itself? No. Why? Economics is a art and science also. See, science is the systematic body of knowledge. Okay, because whatever we study in science, we study with a systematic way. There are two main types of sciences. See, when we think of science, there are two main types of science. First is natural sciences, and second is social sciences. Now you must be remembering something, that you have heard the word social sciences, right, in your scholastic subjects. And this is the new topic, that is natural sciences. You know everything, but you are not able to recall it. What is meant by natural sciences and what is meant by social sciences? I will remind you. See, there are two main types of sciences, natural sciences and social sciences. What is natural sciences? See, natural sciences is one whose laws are universally acceptable and their validity can be tested in a laboratory under controlled conditions. Natural sciences are also called exact sciences because of their empirical approach to the study. For example, mathematics, physics, chemistry. See, these are why it is called as empirical approach. See, it is an evidence-based approach that relies on real world data to study and interpret the information. Interpret means to come to a conclusion or analyze. Okay, see, natural sciences, if you understand, mathematics, physics and chemistry comes under the natural sciences. If you just simply understand that this subjects, mathematics, physics, chemistry comes under natural sciences. Why natural sciences? Because this, whatever you learn, that is based on exact sciences. Okay, why? Because they have empirical approach. It needs evidence. Empirical means, see, for learning mathematics, physics, chemistry, evidence is required. Okay, that science is based only on evidence. What is meant by evidence? Evidence means proof. Okay, see, there are some, it is based on some formulas, some techniques, right? My mathematics, physics and chemistry based on some formulas, some techniques, because it requires some evidence to prove it. Okay, it requires evidence to prove any formula. So it is exact science. See, these exact science are universally acceptable. See, mathematics is universally applicable. See, for example, Pythagoras theorem, universally applicable. Physics, chemistry, H2O, mix of water, all the theorems are universally acceptable. And their validity means their truth can be tested. See, their truth can be tested in a laboratory under controlled situations. See, for making the water, for example, all of us knows what comes, two hydrogens and one oxygen, right? When they comes together, they mix a drop of water. See, where it is done? It is done in, tested in laboratory under controlled conditions. See, these sciences, physics, chemistry, mathematics, these sciences which can be tested with a proof in a laboratory or which needs an evidence, okay, and which is based on some formulas, such sciences are called as natural sciences, which are everywhere acceptable. Okay, this science is called as natural sciences. Don't worry, you are not going to learn science in economics. This science is in economics. Then what is meant by social science? See, social science is exactly opposite to natural science. Okay, as you have taken commerce, you are not going to learn natural sciences. See, social sciences is called abstract or behavioral science because it is related to the study of some or the other aspect of human behavior. For example, psychology is related to mental aspect of human behavior. Sociology is related to the study of social aspect of man as a member of the society. Human behavior can neither be empirically tested nor can be studied in the laboratory. Hence, the laws of social sciences are not universally, but they are only statements of the general human tendencies. See, what was learnt in natural sciences, that is tested in laboratory and that requires the proof. It is based on formulas and it is universal, that is universally applicable means it is applicable in all the countries. But exactly opposite to it, it is social sciences. What is meant by social sciences? The sciences in which abstract or behavioral changes are learned. Okay, behavioral means what is the behavior pattern of the people. Okay, see, for the study of the human behavior, his psychology, his human behavior, then the study of a social aspect of a man, how the man behaves in a society, how the man, see, these behaviors of the human, with respect to the society are not tested in the laboratory. It is not, see, human behavior, how he behaves with himself, how he behaves with everybody, that is not tested in laboratory. See, it is not based on some evidence, what man behaves yesterday and what man will behave tomorrow, that is not based on any proof, that is not based on any mathematical formula, okay? It is not empirical, right? It is the aspect of man as a member of society. Human behavior can neither be empirically tested nor can be studied in the laboratory. See, it is not based on formulas and it cannot be tested on in laboratory, and it is not based on any proofs or evidences. Hence, the laws of social sciences, see, this is social sciences mean human's behavior with respect to society or human's behavior with respect to him. Okay. So, the laws of human behavior with social science, with social, are not universal, but universal means applicable everywhere. The laws are not, how human behaves with himself, how human behaves with society, these laws are not applicable everywhere, but they are only statements of general human tendencies. Okay, these are the general human tendencies only, that it, we cannot call it as a law of human behavior. But whereas for the natural sciences, there are some laws. Now, refresh your memory. Have you studied the following concepts in the previous textbooks? Which concepts? Types of economic systems you must have learnt in history or civics. Which types of economic systems were there? In standard 9th and 10th you have learnt capitalism, socialism, mixed economy, right? You must have learnt, studied these concepts. Okay, in social science, that is called as social science. History and geography is called as social science. So in social science, you would have learnt these subjects, capitalism, socialism and mixed economics. All these concepts are related to the social science. Okay. Now, in accountancy also you have learnt, came across this person. Which person? Kautilya. Now, in economics also, it is based on the thoughts and views of Kautilya only. See, who is this Kautilya? See, Kautilya was an Indian economist. See, what is the meaning of economics first? Artha means wealth and Shastra means science. See, what you are learning economics, what is called economics in Sanskrit? It is Artha Shastra. And what is Artha? Artha means wealth and Shastra means science. Okay. So, Artha Shastra implies the science of acquiring and managing wealth. Right? What you are going to learn by learning economics? Wealth. What is meant by wealth? Wealth means estate, property, money. So, you are going to learn how to acquire that wealth. Okay, and how to preserve that wealth, how to manage that wealth, that is learnt in economics. Okay, why? Artha means, what is meant by artha? Artha means wealth. Okay, and Shastra means to manage that wealth. Okay, means how to acquire that wealth and how to manage that wealth. Interesting, right? Because everybody is working for getting the wealth. And if you get the wealth, then how to manage that wealth? That is learned by learning economics. See, these days all of us are learning, all of us are listening that GDP of India has gone drastically down, -23.9 in this first sector of this financial year. This is a very bad thing because everybody is stuck with corona. There is lockdown everywhere. But when you computer economics, studies in economics, you will choose any of the great field in economist, and then you have to help India to become strong. Okay, you have to build a strong value, a strong position in the world, and it should be ready to fight with every country. This is possible only if we are economically strong. So, what economics teaches us? To acquire the wealth and to maintain the wealth. Wealth means properties, estate, money, right? essentially, Arthashastra is a treatise on political economy in its broadest sense. What is broadest sense means in a wider sense. In a wider sense, what is meant by Arthashastra? It is a treatise on political economy. Okay, in a political economy that was considered as a treaty. So, who developed Arthashastra? It is Kautilya only. Okay, Kautilya developed Arthashastra. That's why it is called as Kautilya Arthashastra. Kautilya's views on economist. What he said according to economist. What were his views on economist? That is called as key points based on Kautilya's views. Crucial role of the state or government. See, with respect to economics, crucial means important, vital. Okay. Role of the state or government with respect to economics. Focus on creation of wealth as the means to ensure welfare and welfare of the state. See, when we can achieve the welfare of the state, for example, state means not this Maharashtra state, means for example, we are considering India. When we can achieve the welfare of our state India, when we will focus on creation of wealth, when we will focus on creation of generating the wealth and how to ensure the safety of that wealth. Okay. So, we should have to focus on it. Need for efficient administrative machinery for good governance. See, for the good governance, there should be efficient administrative machinery for governing any country or any state. That is very important, that is required. Compilation of political ideas into Arthashastra. See, political ideas must be compiled with Arthashastra. Okay, Arthashastra means economics. Okay. Do you know who is Kautilya? Who was Kautilya? Kautilya was a great statesman, philosopher, economist, and royal advisor during the regime of Chandragupta Maurya. He is also known by the name Chanakya or Vishnugupta. Okay. He is also known as Chanakya or Vishnugupta also. Kautilya authored the ancient Indian political treatise, the Arthashastra. Okay, this Arthashastra was written by Kautilya only. Okay, he was a finance minister in the kingdom of Chandragupta Maurya, King Chandragupta Maurya. Regime means kingdom. In the kingdom of Chandragupta Maurya, Kautilya was a finance minister. And he was looking after and giving all the advices to the King Chandragupta Maurya in the 13th century. Now, we are going to start with, so what was that? That was the evolution of economics. Okay. Now, that was the evolution of economics. Which economics? Ancient economics. And now we are going to learn modern economics. Okay. And if we think about the economist, modern economy, then these are the main three economists which cannot be ignored, right? These are the main three economists who has a great contribution in the field of economy, economic concepts which has given to entire world. These big three economists are Adam Smith, Professor Alfred Marshall and Lionel Robbins. Okay, see, these are the three main economics, you have to always remember them. Okay, Adam Smith, Professor Alfred Marshall and Lionel Robbins. This economist means the people who has done the great achievement in the subject of economics, and they have given their values, their thoughts, their researches to the entire world on the subject of economics. That's why those are called as economists, the people who has given the great contribution in the subject of economics. Okay. The first ever economist whose definition we are going to learn, it is Adam Smith. Who is Adam Smith? Who the person, the economist, was born in Scotland in 1723, means in the 18th century. A Scottish, he was a philosopher. he was born in Scotland. He was the pioneer of political economy. Pioneer means the first person who developed some concept is called as pioneer. He was the pioneer of political economy. The Wealth of Nations and the Theory of Moral Sentiments were his famous books. Which were his famous books? Wealth of Nations and the Theory of Moral Sentiments. He is also called as father of modern economists. This is his most important, which we can say about him. He is a father of economics. It is his first identity. Who is the father of modern economics? Adam Smith. He is celebrated by advocates of free market policies as the founder of free market economics. That you will learn in your senior college. What is meant by free market economy? Okay. Commemorated in the UK, that is United Kingdom, on banknotes printed by two different banks. Okay, that was the achievement done by him. Or that was the big great work done by him. So you can remember for the time that he is called as the father of modern economics. Okay, because we are going to learn modern economics. Whatever you heard or whatever we learned so far, that was about the ancient economies, and ancient economy is related with Indian economics, Indian economist, Indian philosopher Kautilya. And now we are going to learn modern economics. And this person, Adam Smith, has a great contribution in the modern economics. That's why he's called as the father of modern economics. Now see what he has said. Adam Smith's wealth oriented definition of economics. See, he also given a definition of economics, but his definition has the orientation of wealth. Okay, orientation means his definition is centered or considering wealth approach. Okay, his definition, whatever he look after economics, is wealth with the wealth approach, with the look of view of wealth only. That is called as wealth oriented definition of economics. Classical economist Adam Smith, also regarded as the father of economics, he's a classical economist, has given the wealth oriented definition of economics. Out of his many literary contributions to economics, he is the most famous for his piece of work, An Inquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nations. See, this is the name of his book, An Inquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Economics. This is the famous book written by him in 1776. Okay, this was the biggest contribution. This literacy is the biggest contribution towards economics. Sorry. Adam Smith defines economics as a science of wealth. According to him, what is economics? It is a science of wealth. Okay. What are the key points of Adam Smith's definition? We just learnt his definition. And what are the key points means? Main ideas or main concepts you learnt from his definition. Laissez-faire. That is non-intervention of the government. Capital and wealth accumulation. Nature's law in economics affairs, and division of labor as an aspect of growth theory. See, according to him, there would not be the intervention means interfere of the government with people. Okay, so he considers that as per his thoughts, as per the wealth orientation definition, he thinks that there will be the no interference of government with the people. Capital and wealth accumulation. Accumulation means increase. What should increase? Capital should increase and wealth also should increase. Nature's law in economics affair. See, nature's law should is involved in the economic affairs. Division of labor as an aspect of growth theory. Okay, division of labor means what? See, the labor should be divided if you want to grow. So these are the key points of his theory, of his definition. The second one, most important economist, is Professor Alfred Marshall. His name you will hear or you will read many times when you are learning economics. Professor Alfred Marshall, he was an economist between 1842 to 1924, and his biggest contribution in the field of economics is his famous book Principles of Economics. Okay, and that everybody refer, whoever learns economics, whoever wants to do the detailed study in economics, whoever wants to do the PhD in economics, or whoever wants to do a great career in economics, everybody refers this book. That is the famous book, his famous biggest contribution to the world of economics, that is his famous book Principle of Economics, written by Alfred Marshall. He is a great economist. And according to him, what is economics? See, what is his definition? Neoclassical economist Professor Alfred Marshall has given the welfare-oriented definition. See, he has also given welfare-oriented definition of economics. Okay? In the book, the name of the book is Principles of Economics, which was published in 1890. Okay, what is this welfare-oriented definition of economics according to him? Okay, what his defined state, his definition states, economics is a study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. It examines that part of individual and social action which is closely connected with the attainment and use of material requisites and well-being. See, there are many new words for you, but don't worry, I will explain you. I am there to explain you. Economics is what? It is a study of mankind. What is meant by mankind? The behavior of man. Economics is the study of the behavior of the man in the business of life. Okay, how the man behave, how the man will behave in the business circle. It is examines that part of individual and social action, what a man will behave in the business with the social action, with his actions, which is closely connected with the attainment. His actions means his behaviors. Okay, whatever he takes the decision and whatever he behaves, that is closely connected with the attainment. Attainment means achievements, gaining, and the use of material requisites of well-being. So whatever is surrounding to him, right, in simple words I will tell you, whatever is surrounding to him, what he will do? He will try to get the maximum benefits from his surroundings for his well-being. That is what? The study of his behavior with respect to the social. Okay, so he will try to make the material requisites from the surroundings for his well-being. That is learned in by, that is the, according to the definition of Professor Alfred Marshall. Welfare oriented. Okay, welfare means prosperity. See, what are the key points of Marshall's definition, Professor Alfred Marshall's definition? Study of an ordinary man. Okay, according to him, economics studies an ordinary man. Economics is a behavioral science. See, it studies the behavioral science of an ordinary man. It studies the material welfare. What it studies? Material welfare. Economics is not simply a study of wealth. It doesn't study wealth. It studies the material welfare. Okay, how the material can be utilized to its maximum and potential unit, so it will give the benefit to the human being. Okay, it studies the human being, ordinary man, his behavior, so how he will get the materialistic welfare. Okay, materialistic welfare means how he will use the material which is surrounding to him for his welfare. Okay, and not only of getting the wealth. Okay, the study of the human behavior, that is according to economics, it is the study of human behavior. So what is material welfare? It refers to the fact or state of having enough housing, clothing, food and possessions, etc., to live comfortably. See, what did I tell you? So using the surrounding things and become the and get the welfare. okay, that is prosperity or well-being. When we say that we are well-being, that we have a place to stay, we have the food, right? We have the clothing, we have some possessions, then we say that they are well-beings, okay? So according to Professor Alfred Marshall, what is the material welfare? That is the state means the phase of human being. State means the phase of human being, when he has the enough housing to stay, enough food to survive, enough clothing and enough possessions. That is called as material welfare, okay? It, according to him, only possessing wealth and maintaining wealth is not the economics, okay? According to Professor Alfred Marshall, because it, according to him, it studies the ordinary man, his behavior and what he will do to have the enough of all these important necessity things, okay? It is studied in economics. Now the third economist, that is Lionel Robbins, okay? He is the third economist, Lionel Robbins, and his famous book is An Essay on the Nature and Significance of Economic Science. See, this is the name of his famous literature, famous book of Lionel Robbins, An Essay on the Nature and Significance of Economic Science. Okay, we'll see. Definitions of economics. According to Lionel Robbins, scarcity oriented definitions. What is meant by scarcity? Scarcity means a phase or a state when there are not sufficient supplies in the market, okay? When people are facing the least of something, okay? They are not getting sufficient of any material. That is called as scarcity, okay? Now, according to Lionel Robbins, this is the most popular definition of economics. Robbins, in his book entitled as, what is the name of his book? An Essay on the Nature and Significance of Economics Welfare. In this book, which was published in 1932, so we can find out that he is the latest one, he is the latest economics among the three which you have seen this now. In his book published in 1932, mentions about the scarcity oriented definition of economics. What is scarcity? We'll see in detail. This is the most popular definition of economics, that is about the scarcity oriented definition of economics. Economics is a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternate uses. See, what it studies according to him also, it studies the human behavior. Economics studies the human behavior with, in relation to what? Ends means what? Ends means we can call it as basic needs. What are the ends? For example, house to stay, food to satisfy our hunger, then clothes to wear. So these are the ends. So the relationship between these ends and the scarce means what? The actual materials. For example, to satisfy hunger is an end. For example, we will see hunger is one of the end, basic necessity, okay? Hunger is the end, and to satisfy this hunger, what is required? What is the means? It is food. Okay, to satisfy hunger as an end, what is the requirement? It is food. Another example, basic needs, if we talk about, to satisfy the, what is the basic requirements of the human being? For example, shelter. Okay, to satisfy the basic requirement of shelter, okay, it is a end, and for this end, to satisfy, what is required? A house is required, right? Or a home is required. Okay, now home is what, or house is what? It is a means the medium. You can consider means medium. See, which medium is used to satisfy the basic need of hunger? It is food. Which medium is used to satisfy the basic need of shelter? It is house. So these are the means. Which are the means? Food, हाउस क्लोथिंग्स और पोजिशंस दीज आर द मीडियम्स एंड वॉट आर द एंड्स एंड्स मीन्स वॉट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स शेल्टर हंगर क्लोथिंग राइट सो दीज आर द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स सो इट अंडरस्टैंड द ह्यूमन बिहेव हाउ द ह्यूमन विल बिहेव दैट इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू हिज रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड द मटेरियल्स विच फुलफिल्स द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ओके वॉट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स शेल्टर हंगर थर्स्ट ओके हाउ द थर्स्ट इज क्वेंच्ड बाय वॉटर सो शेल्टर हंगर थर्स्ट क्लोथिंग आर द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स बेसिक नीड्स एंड वॉट आर द मीन्स ऑफ सेटिस्फाइंग दोज नीड्स फूड हाउस क्लोथिंग वॉटर राइट सो दीज आर द मीन्स सो इफ देर आर द स्कार्स मीन्स लेस अवेलेबल देन द रिक्वायरमेंट ओके रिक्वायरमेंट इज मोर एंड द अवेलेबिलिटी इज लेस देन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्कार्स सो दिस मीन्स फूड हाउस आर स्कार्स और मीन्स लेस अवेलेबल देन इट्स रिक्वायरमेंट देन हाउ ह्यूमन बी विल बिहेव विथ हिज अल्टरनेटिव यूजेस हाउ ह्यूमन विल चूज हिज अल्टरनेटिव वेज दैट इज लर्न एज पर द इन रिक्वायरमेंट्स एज पर लियोनेल रॉबिन्स ओके What are the key points of Robbins' definition? Wants. See, basic requirements are wants. Okay, wants are unlimited. See, people has unlimited wants. Means are comparatively limited. What is means? Means the mediums which satisfies the wants. Okay, which are the wants? For example, shelter is a want. Hunger is a want. Thirst is a want. Clothing is a want. Right? So these are the wants, basic wants. Now, how these wants are satisfied? Shelter is satisfied by house. Okay. Then hunger is satisfied by food. Thirst is satisfied by water. And clothing is satisfied by clothes. So these four, okay, these four are means and means mediums to satisfy these four basic wants or ends see these are also called as ends means basic wants remember these concepts very clearly because this is the base of your economics these are called as the basic wants you know this since you are learning in school okay these four are called as the basic wants basic necessities of the human being and how those basic necessities are satisfied that is called as means okay that is called as means mediums by what these basic requirements are satisfied those are called as means okay now wants these means ends of wants are unlimited because every day our wants are increasing day by day see wants are unlimited there is no end for our wants but at the same time means are limited okay means the materials which satisfies our wants are limited comparatively very limited so wants are gradable on the basis of priority okay see if we have less money and we want to have fashionable clothes we want to have the food okay then what we will choose we will have the priority of food if we have the less money why money is what money is the means which satisfy many of the wants okay so we have the less money so what we will do we will have the priority of getting food first okay so if the means are limited then human will go for grading means he will decide what he will have so he will give the priority to the important thing so wants are gradable on the basis of priority means have alternative uses which are the means see these means have alternative uses means we can sacrifice good clothing if we want the food first okay so they are the alternative uses according to definition according to Leonis Robbins it is economist is scarcity oriented concept okay scarcity means there are less number of or limited number of means as compared to unlimited wants that is called as scarcity Now, let's move to the most important concept of economics, that is branches of economics. Okay, what is meant by branches? Actually, there are not branches of economics. For example, if you think about science, then what you will think? Which are the branches of science? Physics, chemistry, biology, which are three different branches of science. And in every branch, total different subjects are learned. But here, it is not like that. In economics, actually, there are not different branches. It is the different view of learning economics, different approach of learning economics is called as branches of economics. Okay, in which way you are learning economics, which area or which scope of economics are you learning, according to that there are some concepts are there. Okay, that's why we call them as a branch of economics. Okay, which according to the scope means area, how much you are learning in this economics, according to that there are some branches in the economics. See, there are two microeconomics. First is microeconomics and second is macroeconomics. Okay, microeconomics and macroeconomics are the two main branches of modern economics. The term micro, see what is meant by micro, is derived from the Greek word micros. Okay, see, micros is the Greek word. From this Greek word, the term micro has been derived. What is meant by micro? Micro means small or a millionth part, very small part. That is meant by micro. Whereas, exactly opposite to it, the term macro. Macro is derived from the Greek word macros. Okay? Macros, which means large. Okay? These terms were coined. Coined means what? First developed. Who developed these terms first? By the Norwegian economist Ragnar Fish of Oslo University in 1933. That's why these are called as modern economics. Recently, okay, just 80 years ago, these terms coined by Norwegian economist Ragnar Fish in 1933, which according to whom there are two main branches of economics, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Okay, micro means small and macro means large. This is the basic concept you can understand. Micro is derived from the Greek word micros and macro is derived from the Greek word macros. What is learned according to microeconomics? Smaller things. And what is learned according to macroeconomics? Bigger things. Okay, what is this smaller things and what is this bigger things? We'll see. But first of all, just remember, branches of economics means the way of learning, okay, the approach of learning the economics or the way of considering the economics as its scope, smaller or bigger. According to that scope only two branches has made, okay, the two branches has been coined, microeconomics and macroeconomics. See, there are two types of economics. Branches of economics, microeconomics and macroeconomics. See, macroeconomics and microeconomics. As I told you, micro means small, individual, small part. Okay, see, in macroeconomics, whole, entire, big, large. Okay, if we think of a person, if we just think, consider an example of a person, then person, a single person, an individual. An individual behavior, okay, what an individual behaves in a specific condition, individual, particular. To understand or study a particular individual behavior, it is studied under microeconomics. Why? Because it studies individual. And what is the big scope or big large of human being? We can say it is a society, right? So, economy as a whole means learning the economy of entire society, entire state, entire country, that is learnt in macroeconomics. A single consumer will be learnt in microeconomics. So, these are called as the branches of economics. In 1933, Sir Ragnar Fish coined the term. Coined means he did came across a new term. Okay. He coined the terms microeconomics and macroeconomics. These terms are derived from the Greek words micros and macros respectively. Now, what is studied in microscope? What is studied in microeconomics? See, what is micro? When we study the micro, see these days everybody is studying the behavior of coronavirus. Okay, so how the virus is studied? It is studied using the microscope. Why? It is what is the size of the coronavirus? Micro. It cannot be seen by the eyes. So it is studied by the microscope. Why? It is a very small small particle. Okay, so what is studied in microeconomics? See, whatever is studied in microeconomics, it is considered, it is assumed that it is studied in a microscopic way. Microscopic way means a detailed study of a single, okay, individual, particular, in a detailed way. That's why it is called as a microscopic study. Microscopic study is done in microeconomics. Okay, so or we can say the economics in which the study of individual particular is done in a microscopic way, that economics is called as microeconomics. Okay, see, the first term is branch of economics is microeconomics. Micro means small. Microeconomic deals with the behavior of the individual variables such as household, worker, firm, industry, etc. What does this mean? What is learnt in microeconomics? The behavior of a single person, individual, single person, single house, single worker, single company, single firm, single industry, okay, individual vegetable, whatever with individual, single, particular, that is learnt in microeconomics. And the behavior of all these single variables, like which single variables? Can be single home, single employee, right, single student, single teacher, single school, okay. So all these single things are learnt in details in microeconomics. Okay, that's why it is called as study in a way, in a scope of micro but in detail. Okay, micro means single, but that single is learnt in detail. Okay, now micro means a small part of a thing. Microeconomics thus deals with a small part of the national economy. It studies the economic actions and behavior of individual units, such as an individual consumer, individual producer, or a firm, the price of a particular commodity or a factor, etc. See, these individual producers, individual producer means a company owner, a factory owner, okay, the businessman, a single businessman, or a single firm, the price of a particular commodity. What is meant by commodity? Now, see, you are in economics, you are going to learn some economic concepts or economic terms. Okay, now you will not be considered to call customer. Okay, so what is the economic term to customer? It is consumer. Okay, similarly, what you call to things, materialistic things, in economics it is called as commodity or goods. Okay, you have to remember these economic terms. See, there are always these kinds of terms are there in each new subject. Okay, every new subject has their own terms or terminology, that is called as terminology. Each language has its own terminology. Okay, see, for example, as I told you, you will not call customer, okay, you have to call consumer. It is the same, person is same, but as per that economical terminology, you should call customer. Similarly, for the goods, for the things, you should call commodity. Okay, and what is learned? A particular commodity, a particular producer, a particular firm, or a particular factor, etc. All these particulars are learnt in microeconomics. Okay, what it is learned? Actions and behaviors of individual units. How a particular firm will behave, how a particular human consumer will behave, how a particular worker will behave. Okay, so the behaviors of all those individual units are learnt under the scope of microeconomics. See, when we think of microeconomics, micro, what is meant by micro? Micro means small, minute. Okay, so microeconomics, see, if we consider the social, okay, then what is the minute of the social? Single person. Right? Micro means small. So microeconomic deals with the behavior of the individual. Which are the individual variables? Such as a single household, a single worker, a single firm, a single industry, etc. Okay, what is the difference between firm and industry? See, industry is the business where manufacturing works are conducted. Okay, manufacturing means production of something. So these you must be learning or listening these words first time, okay? But as you have entered in the world of commerce, entered in the stream of commerce, these new words you have to understand and remember forever, okay? Industry is the unit or the business function where manufacturing or production is done, okay? And firm is the business, okay, or the company where other administrative works are done, other services will be given, okay, that is called as firm. Okay, for example, when have you ever been to CA's office? CA, who is CA? CA is the chartered accountant. Okay, so you must have gone to this office of CA. Then who is he? It is a firm, it is not an industry. Okay, so that is a firm, and the people who works in the firms, okay, or the different businesses are called as employees. This is again a new term for you, okay? Employee. Employee are the people who works in the firms, okay? Then everybody works in the firm, you can say. Then what is called to other people? The people who works in the industry for manufacturing purpose are called as workers, okay? Always remember this differentiation. Okay, there are the workers who works in industry. Okay, it is also called as laborers, workers or laborers who works in industry, and employees works in firms or in offices, you can say. Simply to distinguish between them, you can say offices, workers. Then what you are going to learn? You are going to learn the behavior of individual industry, individual firm, individual worker, individual household. Household means a house. Okay, that is learnt in the scope of microeconomics. See, this is an example given. What is learnt in microeconomics? This is shown a single home. What is learnt with home? See, we are again and again saying that in the behavior of a single home, behavior of a single household. What does this mean? Behavior of a single household. It means how much of income is coming in that home. Okay, and how the people in that single home are utilizing that income, utilizing that money. Okay, that is learnt of a single home. The behavioral pattern of a single home is learnt in microeconomics. Or a single firm, okay, can be a single firm, a single business. Okay, how the firm behaves, how the money comes in that business, and how they spend the money, that is learnt in with reference to a individual firm. Then individual prices. See, this is the symbols of R. R means rupees are given. Individual prices means price of a single kg of onion, price of single kg of potatoes. Okay, so the prices of single are learnt in microeconomics. Okay, see, this picture is a good idea to understand. What is this? This is the group of people. Okay, these are the group of people. Now, what microeconomics studies? It doesn't study the group of people. It studies a single person from this group of people, and he studies that single person. Who microeconomics? According to microeconomics, a single person, behavior of a single person is studied among the group, okay, not of the group, according to microeconomics. See, what is the meaning of microeconomics? Micro means a small part of a thing. Small part of a thing. Microeconomics does this with a small part of the national economy. Okay, so what it learns? Small part of national economy. What is national economy? The economy of an entire nation. That is called as national economy. It studies the economic actions and behaviors of individual units, such as individual consumer, individual producer, or a firm, the price of a particular commodity, or a factor, etc. See, what does this mean? Micro means small. And what it learns? A small part of the national economy. This is national economy. And what is the small part of national economy? The economy of our own home, the economy of me, myself, etc. Myself, okay? So, in microeconomics, the economy of a single individual person, a single individual house is learned, or a single individual firm, a single individual company, a single individual commodity. Commodity means things, okay? And a factor. What is meant by factor? We will see later on. What is factor? Is the factor of producing that commodity, okay? A single factor. All that single is learned in microeconomics. See, individual income and individual expenditure, individual household, a single home, the incomes and expenditure of a single home. Then if you are thinking about the production company, production firm, then what are its receipts and what are its expenditure, from where that company gets the money and where the company spends its money. That is learnt with respect to a single firm, okay, a single household, a single individual. Okay, all these things are learnt in detail in microeconomics behavior, the behavior of all these things. Okay, and what is meant by macro then? See, macro means economy of an entire country, a government, national income, the scopes with the points of economy which has the big scope. Okay, the national scope are called as macroeconomics. And now we are talking about microeconomics. Okay, single person, single home, single worker, single commodity, okay, single price and the factors of that price, single home, okay, that single is learnt under microeconomics. See, microeconomics is a microscopic study. Actually, microscopy is not taken. Why it is called as microscopic study? See, when you are learning the, see, what is shown in this picture, there are many cells shown over here. And this person is learning the behavior of a single cell. He has extracted a single cell from the cells, okay? And he is learning in detail about a single cell. That's why it is called as microscopic study, okay? And what we are learning in microscopic study? Economics in a microscopic study. That is what? Single human, single behavior of a single pen, single home, single company, single firm, single worker, okay? That single in detail is learnt in microeconomics, under the scope of microeconomics. See, according to Kenneth Boulding, there are different branches of economics, and which are those branches? See, what is the definition of Kenneth Boulding's of microeconomics? What he says? See, microeconomics is the study of a particular firm, particular household, individual prices, wages, incomes, individual industries, particular commodities, etc. See, everywhere which is the keyword particular or individual, or we can say specific, okay, that specific person, the behavior of his specific behavior, then how he behaves in his home, with how, from which source he gets the money, and on which, how he spends the money, that is learned up a particular household, individual prices, wages, incomes, individual industries, particular commodities. All these things are learned in the scope of microeconomics. See, microeconomics, you can consider the difference between this. in microeconomics, you are studying by taking a binocular in your hand, okay? Microscope in your hand and here binocular in your hand. Means we can say microeconomics is studied by a single eye, whereas macroeconomics is studied by keeping both the eyes open because it requires a wide scope. Okay, while learning macroeconomics, it requires a wide scope. That's why it is learned by using binocular. Okay, and microeconomics requires a detailed study of a single individual, maybe commodity, person, whatever. For that, it is taken a microscope. Okay, so this is the basic difference. Microscope is taken in a single eye. It is seen in by a single eye. Okay, so this is the basic difference between micros in economics and macroeconomics. See, what are the two types of economics analysis? Macroeconomics and microeconomics. We'll see macroeconomics first. Macroeconomics looks at the entire economy or its major aggregates, major component sectors such as household, business or government. Whereas microeconomics studies the economic behavior of individuals, particular markets, firms or industries. Which behaviors? Economics behaviors. Okay. It is not studied what he eats after going home, okay, where he goes, from where he comes. That is not learnt under microeconomics. His economic behavior, okay, his behavior with respect to economy is studied under microeconomics. Single firm, single individual, single specific market, specific firm, specific industry, okay, that specific individual is learnt in microeconomics. See, there are two types of microeconomics. We'll see macroeconomics first. Macro, okay, macro means large. Economics that deals with the economy as a whole, entire economy, and decision making by large units, okay. For example, economy of India, then decisions of the what to do in specific condition, that is the decisions, those are learnt in macroeconomics. So macroeconomic explains decisions in employment because it is considered with the social factor, growth of some businesses, labors, okay. So all these learnt in macroeconomics. And what is learnt in microeconomics? See, economics that deals with the behavior of small units like individual or firms. Microeconomics explains how prices are determined and individual income decisions are made, okay, that is learnt under microeconomics. How prices are determined means, see, when we think that when we purchase a pen of rupees 10, then how that rupees 10 has been determined, those are the factors of production, okay. Just now we discuss about factors. So all these factors, individual factors, which makes that pen the worth of rupees 10, that is learnt in microeconomics. Okay, the prices are determined and individual economic decisions are made. So according to that, individual economic decisions are made. Okay, means how much should we spend on buying that refill, okay, and putting that refill into the pen. All these small individual decisions are taken under microeconomics, and big national decisions are taken under macroeconomics. So what are the nature and methods of economics? See, there are two types of economics analysis. Macroeconomics looks at the entire economy or its major components or sectors such as businesses, many businesses, government, okay, because government itself is a whole thing. Wholesome, okay. So all that is learnt in macroeconomics, whereas microeconomics studies the economic behavior of single individual, particular market, particular firm or particular industry, particular household, that is learnt under microeconomics. See, microeconomics deals with behavior of small units like individuals or firms. It explains how prices are determined and individual income decisions are made. Macroeconomics learns national income, unemployment, GDP, inflation. See, these are the big topics to discussion, okay, which has a big scope, unlimited scope we can call, okay, if we think of economy of a single nation, national, considering of national income, unemployment of the entire nation, GDP of the entire nation, inflation with of the entire nation, all those are learnt under macroeconomics, okay. Whereas what is learnt in microeconomics? Simple things, a single consumer, okay, what are the demands of a single consumer, how those demands are satisfied by giving the proper supply, okay, and what prices charged for a single commodity. That is learnt in microeconomics. Single consumer, his single demand, then satisfying his demand by giving him is the supplies and the prices of different goods and services. That is learnt under microeconomics. See, under micro, a single person, then another person, then another person. So single persons are learnt. See, single factory, okay. So single things are learnt. Whereas in macro, entire concepts, issues of entire world are thought, okay, under macro, because it has unlimited or a very big scope. So what we have learnt today? Today we have learnt what is meant by economic. Then who are the biggest or most famous economists? What are their values? What they have told, what they have said according to economics, that we have learnt. And what we will learn in our next lecture? In our next lecture we will see basic concepts of microeconomics with reference to want. So with this want we are going ahead for becoming a good senior college student or to succeed in a senior college student, post graduation and getting the good great job. So basic concepts of microeconomics. So we are going to learn the basic concepts of microeconomics. So how the microeconomics should be learned? With the help of basic concepts. First concept is want. Then you will see the characteristics of want. Then goods and services, utility, value, wealth, personal income, personal disposable income, and the economic activities, different economic activities like production, distribution, exchange and consumption. So all these new points, new things we are going to cover in our next lecture. All these activities, all these basic concepts are given on page number 3 to 6. I hope that you always are preparing before attending the lecture, and even after attending the lecture, I'd appreciate if you read the book again. And you can ask me in the next quiz, next lectures, the quiz of day one. So I am always going to take the quiz on whatever I have taught. So what is the quiz of today, day first? What is not studied under microeconomics? See, it is a good question because it is a basic question which makes your base of microeconomics clear. What is the question? What is not studied under microeconomics? Okay, means four options has been given. Out of the four options, three are such concepts which are studied under microeconomics, and one is the concept which is not studied under microeconomics. Okay, so as this is the first quiz of the day or first quiz of economics, okay, I expect that you answer it immediately and develop the same habit forever. So as soon as the video has been completed, you have to remember what you have learned. Okay, you have to understand whatever has been taught and you have to give the answer immediately. So what is not studied under microeconomics? Four options are there, A, B, C, D. First option is particular firm. Second is national income. Third is particular household. And the fourth is individual prices. Okay, so you have to give the correct answer immediately. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe, take care, and don't forget to learn online.